enthusiastic learner. Today we are going to talk about development. Development means progress. It means something that grows, matures and advances. We all have idea of development or progress in life. We want to progress in life in the same way we expect our country to provide us with facilities, opportunities, good social and economic environment. People seek development by setting up goals. Usually, people set up goals for the things which are most important for them and also according to their life situation. Goals are aspirations or desires. The three main principles of development are, first, different people seek different goals. Let us understand this by the following example. Developmental goal of a landless farmer would probably be regular work, wages as set by the government under Minimum Wages Act, provide basic facilities for his family and send his children to local school. On the other hand, the developmental goal of a prosperous farmer would be to get good support price for his crop from the government, earn big profit, provide luxuries for his family, get cheap and hard-working labor and send his children to expensive schools. Second principle of development is what may be development for one may not be development for the other. It may even be destructive for other. For example, industrialists living in the urban areas want construction of more and more dams to run their industry. They require power which they would get from the dams. But such an act would be destructive for the people living around the area where dams are to be built. They would lose their livelihood. They would have to move out of that area. And this step would be very destructive for them. For them, development would be government builds small check dams and tanks for them to irrigate their land. The third principle of development is people look at mix of goals for development. Even though income is the common goal of all the people, but besides income, people also seek love, security, respect, discrimination-free society, good environment for quality life. So we can say that they look for mix of goal for development, that is income as well as non-materialistic things. Non-materialistic things are very important for quality life. We all know that money plays a very important role in our development because money can make our life comfortable. We can buy many things with money to make our life easy and comfortable. But along with money, we require non-materialistic things like love, respect, security, freedom, discrimination-free society, etc. to enjoy quality life, which is very important for development. Let us understand this by the following example. Anil has got a job in Delhi where there is good infrastructure, good schools for his children and good development opportunities for his family. He is offered a job in a far-flung area of Andhra Pradesh where he is being paid double the salary. But that area lacks infrastructural development. There are no good schools over there. He cannot move his family along with him. So he will not have the company of his family. There is no job security as well. Even though the job is giving him double the income, but in most probability, he will not accept that job which pays him double, but he cannot enjoy the other non-materialistic things. Here, non-materialistic things become very important for him. So far, we have seen what is development and what are the principles of development. Now, we will look into national development. As we all know, different people have different notion of development. In the same way, different people have different and conflicting notion of development. National development would be such that takes a fair and just path for all, not favoring any particular section of the society. So we can say national development is the development which benefits a large number of people living in the country. Comparison of different countries. We compare countries into developed, developing and underdeveloped countries. For comparison of anything, we take one or more characteristics. For comparison of countries, income is an important attribute. Income of a country is the total income earned by all the people living in that country. But this will not be a very important attribute as the size and population of every country varies. So we take average income for comparison. Average income is the total income of the country divided by total population of the country. But there are some drawbacks in this average income. Average income is also called per capita income. The drawbacks are that it hides disparity and it does not show how every section of the society is earning. The criteria used by World Bank for classifying countries according to 2012 World Development Report is rich countries income per annum US dollar 12,616, middle income countries US dollar 1,530, low income countries US dollar 1,035 or less. Now, let us consider some of the questions on the topic done so far. What is development? 2. What are the indicators of economic development? 3. What would be the developmental goal of an Adivasi? 4. Which three developmental goals would you prescribe for a rural laborer? Next question. Mention the common developmental goals of people. Why do people look at mix of goals for development? What is national development? What is the main criteria used by World Bank for classifying countries? What is the per capita income? What are the limitations of per capita income? Explain with example. Thank you for watching my video. If you like the video, please do share and subscribe to my channel.